Well, Allied Electronics, Altron, reported a 4% rise in headline earnings per share to 82 cents, and revenue grew 8% to 13.4 billion rand. Our Chief Executive Robbie Venter is in the studio now for a look at the numbers. Thanks for coming in, Robbie. I always like to look at those revenue and earnings, and if the revenue is X and the earnings are X plus something, that sounds like you've done something good. If the revenue is X and the earnings is X minus something, then your revenue is not reflected in your earnings. So perhaps let's just start there and see what the difficulty was. And you said also that your EBITDA was down by 4% or 1% after being normalized.
Yeah, I think, David, if you have a look at that the normalized number is the most transparent way of looking at the financial numbers. So at the EBITDA level, we were roughly flat at the EBITDA level with good increase in revenue. At the headline earning, normalized headline earnings per share, we were actually up 15%, which is, I think, representative of the business going forward. However, margin pressure at Powertech, it remains a very challenging market that we're operating in, much improved from performance from the second half of last year, but margins under pressure. We saw some EBITDA margin improvement at Eltec, and that was a lot of that was related to the divestiture of East and West Africa in the prior year, and Bytes a slight decrease in the EBITDA margin. So margin pressure is evident in the markets that we serve, and that requires efficiencies and requires things to be done smarter, better, and quicker.
Let's take a step back and look at the company and the companies over the last 3, 4 to 5 years. What would you say the problem was? Now, presumably what you've done by taking out Eltec from being a listed company, owning that completely now, what did you see as the problem and how have you gone about solving it?
Yeah, I think really this reporting period is the first glimpse that people get of what I like to call the new Altron. And there's two major differences to the Altron of the last couple of years. Obviously, we had some real challenges in East and West Africa in terms of our businesses there, which we divested at the end of last year. And then the second major factor was the acquisition of the Eltec minorities in what's our biggest acquisition ever, 1.8 billion rand acquisition. Yeah. Now, that was only completed effectively of the 1st of August. So the impact of that in the numbers was only 1 month of the 6 months, whereas the divestiture of East Africa was in there for the full 6 months.
It looks like a different company now, and I think a lot of people would say that it's cleaner, that the shareholding is cleaner, and there were questions asked about why we needed those two separate listed companies with cross shareholdings and so on. But also you mentioned Powertech, you mentioned Bytes. It strikes one that there's a lot of reliance on a couple of companies. Big companies, important companies, but a lot rests on those companies.
Yeah, I think that's...
More so now that you're not diversely involved in Africa.
Yeah, that's correct. I mean, we have a number of key cornerstone companies, and if you look at the top five contributors to Altron, it includes companies like Eltec Netstar and Eltec Autopage and Bytes Managed Solutions and UEC. Eltec UEC, but you know that diversity, so there's a lot of diversity one level down from the Eltec Bytes and Powertech level that helps us to weather some storms, but obviously we want to remain focused and only really be involved in what we do best.
Looking at, one's always interested to know what CEOs of big companies think about the economy and how you're exposed to it. I mean, where are you expecting us to be? People are talking about 2% growth. There are many who say we weren't going to hit 2% this year, which has been revised down several times, and that is obviously going to affect you.
Yeah, I think that's right. I mean, the original forecasts of around 3% are now down to about 2%. But what's quite interesting is that when I travel to our international operations, and they're primarily in Iberia and in the UK and Australia, you go to some of those operations and you hear the CEOs of those operations talking about their economies, and they only wish for a 2% growth rate that we get in South Africa. So sometimes I think we're a bit harsh on ourselves in terms of the global position that we're in, and even though it's lower than what we expected, at least we're showing, as a country, we're showing some growth. And then obviously Africa going forward is a big opportunity, and the GDP growths in Africa outside of South Africa are 5-6%.
Well, let's pause there. Is it fair to say you've burnt your fingers in Africa? What did you do wrong? What would you do differently if you went in again? Because most South African companies are going to have to get into the rest of Africa.
Yeah, so the divestiture of East and West Africa was not a vote of no confidence in Africa. Africa was and remains a critical pillar for Altron's growth. We're just refining our strategy, and our focus going forward is going to be more around less acquisitions in Africa and buying actual operations on the ground, where we have made some mistakes, and it's different environments, different markets, so we're not the only ones.
Why don't some of those big companies, Powertech, Bytes, Altec, Netstar, and those companies, why don't they expand under the umbrella of the bigger company?
They do, and just to give you some evidence of that, Bytes and Altec very much a follow your customer strategy, so their biggest customers in South Africa are the retailers and the banks, who have their own international strategies in Africa, and as a trusted partner, we're leveraging off that. So companies like Absa, Barclays, where we've been very successful, ShopRite, and other of the leading retailers and banks, we're very active with in following in Africa. In fact, our Africa revenues are up about 22% year 6 month period on 6 month period, and we're selling about 630 odd million rands worth of business in Africa, up from 500 last period, 6 month period.
So in fact, you're not out of Africa.
No, absolutely.
There's a lot
not.
Of exposure to Africa, and it's growing.
Yeah, absolutely.
A year from now, when you come into the studio and talk about the results, you mentioned that only 1 month of the new structure has filtered through into these results, and you talk about still concerned with rigorous cost control, working capital management, efficiency. So it sounds like a tough period ahead, and maybe a bit of pain for the business.
I think we've seen the worst, and I think we've turned a very significant corner. I'd like to see our new TMT division, the combined Altec and Bytes, extracting some of the synergies, cost-wise and also revenue-wise, out of the new structure, and that coming through in the next 6 month period. And Powertech enters this 6 month period for the first time with a much improved order book of some 500 million improvement over the year end last year.
If such dramatic things are going to happen, why did you take so long to do this?
Well, the Altec transaction was something that we did attempt some many years ago. And in fact, we started this process of focusing on one listed entry point for the group 10 years ago when I came into, or more than 10 years ago when I came into the group. So we've gone from about 9 listed entities to where we are today, which was the end game. Yes, it took us a bit longer, but we had various issues as to why we were successful this time round versus why we weren't successful previously when we tried to take out the Altec minorities.